privileged to be with you tonight. I know it's Birkbeck's first annual development lecture, and I was extremely honoured and delighted when I got the invitation from Jasmine and Penny almost a year ago now. I think they know I have a fairly busy schedule, so they thought they'd better book me up well in advance. So since my mother's going to be 80 on Saturday, I knew I'd be in the country around this time, so that's why we settled on this Thursday. I'm fully aware that development studies at Birkbeck has positively flourished during the last decade, and particularly during the years since Jasmine, Penny and Kulpana have been on the team. And I'm always hearing from Penny in our socials, my godmother to Letty, Penny's child, always hearing how wonderful you students are here at Birkbeck, highly motivated, dynamic, and bringing lots of things to the table. So it sounds very much like my LSE students, and I'm very happy to see a couple in the audience tonight. Now, in taking up the theme of the feminisation of poverty, I know I'm in very good company indeed, since the research of colleagues such as Jasmine, Penny and Kulpana intersect in several ways with my own interests, and indeed, as Jasmine said, they all have chapters in the International Handbook of Gender and Poverty. Jasmine's is on gender, health and poverty in Chile. Penny's is on old age, pensions and poverty in southern India. And Kulpana's was on picturing women in poverty, which critiqued some of the images used by development organisations to represent poor women in developing contexts.